From the Gateway Arch to the Gate City, WXII 12 takes you behind the gates of Arendelle for an inside look at Disney's Frozen. Welcome to Arendelle. We're taking a behind-the-scenes look at Disney's Frozen, coming to First Bank Broadway at Tanger Center beginning in May. Disney's Frozen, the hit Broadway musical, brings its ice and snow to the Triad for 2.5 weeks starting May 17th. All of your favorite characters from the 2013 Academy Award-winning animated movie will be there live on stage.
Seeing them is like seeing an old friend that they haven't seen in a long time.
It's a story for young people, for grown people, for grandparents.
It's a story many of us know by heart.
About two sisters who are really trying to find each other because of, you know, a secret that's kept them apart.
Now made into a Broadway blockbuster with added perks.
There's about a dozen new songs that the writers have put into the Broadway show.
It's got incredible, huge numbers, huge dance numbers, incredible costumes.
It's that big, magical Broadway moment that we've all been waiting for.
So sit back and relax as we take you on a backstage tour with the cast and crew who will bring Frozen to the Triad.
Come have a snow day with us.
Frozen blows into town on 20 trucks carrying sets, costumes, lights, and other special effects. It takes 3 days to create the world of Frozen on stage, complete with its castle at Arendelle and all of that ice and snow. Creating Frozen's icy scenes on stage requires a lot of work, including moving this ice bridge. The bridge weighs about 7,000 pounds, but slides into place like it's gliding on skates. There's also an ice palace with curtains featuring 20,000 crystals that shine and sparkle. There's a lot of light and reflection as almost all the surfaces on stage act as mini projection walls, which allow them to shimmer like fallen snow and ice. The largest surface is the 6,000-pound video wall with roughly 4.7 million LEDs. Its video is much like a 4K TV. Bringing that set to life for all of Frozen's beloved characters who require a lot of imagination to create. Let's check out some of the fan favorites.
Everybody remembers Sven from the movie, but you're not quite sure if it's even going to be in the show or how it's going to be in the show.
Dan Plihal brings Sven to life on stage. Before every show, the magic begins with key dresser and puppet supervisor Sue McLaughlin, who's worked for Disney for over 20 years, and she brings her Lion King puppet experience to Frozen.
It's a big undertaking to sort of deny the shape of a human and make him into a full reindeer.
A lot of people think that there's two people inside or that it's, like you said, a robot. There are some kids young enough even finish the show and ask what do they feed the reindeer off stage because they think it's real.
He sure looks real, but it's just a bit of Disney magic.
I've got all these straps on these boots which help stabilize my ankles, since when I get onto the stage, my whole foot is off the ground,
oh,
sort of walking
goodness.
Around
wow.
like that.
So it's almost like a ballerina position.
Sort
though.
Of, yeah. In fact, many of the men that have played this role and women that have played this role come from ballet backgrounds. I don't. I'm from an acrobatic background, but it's still a similar idea of you need strong ankles and strong legs and a lot of stabilizing muscles and balance.
And he's balancing quite a load.
He comes in around 40 pounds, but then later in the show, he has a few things piled onto him that he carries up the mountain, and that gets him closer to 80 or 90 pounds.
It takes a lot of care, too, to not get ourselves injured. We have a physical therapist named Sammy Harmon who travels around with us, and we both spend a lot of time with her. Do a lot of warm-up for each show. I'm usually warming up for about 45 minutes before the show.
Since the role of Sven is so physically demanding, it's played by two actors, each doing 4 shows a week.
And it'll stabilize the weight so that not all of the weight of the head is on my neck, but instead some of it goes through to my back. This piece that I'm putting on now is called the carapace. It's essentially the body of the reindeer. It gives me the shape of a larger torso that a reindeer would have. So the last piece is a little hat. to just make it smoother underneath the helmet. This is about what I wear for the whole show. We put me into this once and I stay for the whole show, and then we get in and out of this buddy a bunch of times anytime I need to go on stage. It's a helmet that is molded to my head and built into this so that I can control it, can move it around, can bring the animal to life. Because the most important thing that we're doing here is telling the story and letting this character be a part of the story that we're telling. Here's when we strap in.
Can you see out of it?
Yes, somewhat. I'm generally looking.
I can't see the audience faces.
I can't see the audience. I'm generally looking at the floor. There's a lot of marks on the floor that I use as spacing. I often can't see the eyes of the actors I'm interacting with, but it's fun to get to know their body language so I know kind of how they're interacting with me.
When you're ready, tipping forward.
Sven stands a little over 7 feet and is about 5.5 feet long from nose to tail.
You know, we don't have a whole lot of snow. When you come to North Carolina, you'll have to bring the winter. Are you going to survive in the warm weather in North Carolina? Can you do two?
Sven is only one of the magical creations on stage. Beloved snowman Olaf is brought to life as a puppet remotely controlled by actor Jeremy Davis.
We're sort of like dance partners, really. It's such an exciting challenge. When we're working together and I feel my voice coming through his mouth, it's really a thrilling experience. And to hear kids out there loving him, it's just really lovely.
Olaf brings out the child in everyone and provides some of the lighter moments on stage.
When I first come on, they don't know I'm there, and I keep talking, and they're like, wait, just listen. I start to listen, and then they see me, and they say, was that there a minute ago? And I say, shh, we're supposed to be listening. And they freak out and run all over the place. And I say, all right, let's start this thing over. Hi, everyone. I'm Olaf, and I like warm hugs.
Still ahead, Frozen fashion. A look at the costumes and the dress with over 10,000 beads and crystals.
I'm so excited. We are backstage with our assistant wardrobe supervisor, Tiffany, who is also from North Carolina.
Hi.
I love it. Yeah, and you get to take this back to Greensboro in the Triad.
Do,
are you excited about that?
I can't wait. UNCG being my alma mater, it's going to be an amazing experience to be back in that town.
So tell everyone what you do here and what you're going to show us.
Sure. Well, first let me introduce you to Gondola Row. This is what we call this area backstage, where all of our ensemble gets in and out of their costumes.
There are 154 costumes on stage every night, and every piece is custom made for the show. There are 30 different kinds of faux fur. Fabrics are sourced from 17 different countries, all with plenty of adornments.
We see this flower, this motif, showing up not only on the costumes, but also on stage. But specifically in the costumes, we see it on King Agnar's beautiful jacket here. We see it on the guards decorating their
sleeves. I love the sparkle
sleeves.
Too, the shine and shimmer.
The brightest of all costumes, Elsa's ice dress.
Fun fact for you, it takes one person 42 days to bead that gown. And there are over 10,000 beads and crystals attached.
Wow.
But it's pretty remarkable. I seriously can't believe I wear this every day. I look in the mirror and I'm like, okay, wow, your job's pretty cool.
What is your favorite costume?
My favorite costume has to be the ice dress.
It is, okay.
It's just so beautiful.
Yeah, it is.
It's spectacular, and how can you not feel like somebody important when you're handling it?
It fills my heart. Like, I mean, my heart flutters, like, talking about it.
Every night, the audience gets to experience the beauty of not one, but two elegant gowns.
In fact, I actually get into this dress on stage. My lovely handmaidens help me into that. So that's a transformation that the whole audience gets to see right off the bat.
Anna busts out of the gates to one of the classic songs from the movie, For the First Time in Forever. And it's the first time you see everyone on stage.
For the first time in forever, just all of us getting to walk through the gates, it's sort of, I feel like, the audience's first real look into who everyone is on stage, and it's just such an amazing Disney magic moment that I really love.
For the First Time in Forever is one of those memorable songs from the movie, but the Broadway show builds on that by adding new blockbuster musical numbers.
Now there's about a dozen new songs that the writers have put into the Broadway show, which is another reason for people to come see it. Even if they think they've seen the movie and they know everything, there's so much more material that comes along with this production.
I think you wanted to find more depth and to get into the relationships and more sophistication.
There's a new duet with Anna and Elsa. It's called I Can't Lose You.
Why can't you turn to me? I'm trying to tell you that I can lose you.
It's just a moment between the sisters looking into each other's eyes and trying to connect and actually seeing each other for the first time, like seeing their real selves. It's the first time Elsa's fully herself in front of her sister, and it's very vulnerable. And Anna is saying, I see you and I love you still.
Anna is really committed to getting Elsa to listen to her and let's work together. And Elsa is like, I need to protect you. You need to stay away from me. So that's what's so interesting about that number.
All I'm saying is when you go to climb a mountain, you don't just jump to the top.
If it's true love, you can.
I think some of the best songs are the newer ones that they added. There's a song that I sing with Anna on the ice bridge called What Do You Know About Love? And that is just a head banging bop. The entire, yeah, I love that one.
What do you know about love?
Right now, I love doing Love is an Open Door with Lauren Chapman. She's just so fun to play with on stage, and I've known that song forever since the movie came out, and it's so fun to get to do every night.
And they make it look so easy.
Right.
And he's flipping her upside down. That's another thing your audience can look forward to. And he's carrying her on his back, and they're both singing as if nothing else is happening, but it's very difficult.
The best part about Love is an Open Door is that it's a very like awkward number between the two, and they're finding their love for each other. So it like transitions from like this smooth like to goofy dancing. That's my favorite part about it.
And during the dance part of that, so Stephen Arenas, our music supervisor, modeled this after Pete Townsend's Let My Love Open the Door.
Oh, really?
Yes, so Let My Love Open the Door. But that's from Love is an Open Door, so another musical Easter egg.
There are plenty of musical gems along the way, including Let It Go.
When the music starts for Let It Go, I feel like I am alone on this mountain filled with snow, and I am playing pretend and discovering my power from within.
Everyone that loved the movie is gonna get to see Let It Go, but they've never seen it like this.
But on our show, it's the blockbuster ending of the first act, and they have to belt this high note and hold it, and it's just a wonderful way to end the show.
Still ahead, a not-so-frozen heart, the unique love story at the center of Frozen that comes alive on stage. Frozen is full of magical moments that will warm your heart. At the heart of this show, a love story.
It's about the love of family. It's about how important our families are to us.
That was not about a prince and a princess and happily ever after, but that love can exist within family units as well and does exist within family units.
It's not the classic true love that we've heard all these years, right? True love within sisterhood, within friendship. And as I mentioned before, I think what makes it so special is celebrating those differences and ultimately raising each other up.
This is redefining true love, mm-hmm. what we look at, or recentering what true love really means, and it can be so much more than just a love between a prince and a princess, which is what we've seen for so many years.
There's so many young audiences and families that come, and I think it's really powerful for them to see the love between the two sisters, and especially at the end of the show, I feel like you can't leave feeling happy and some kind of connection to love and the loved ones around you.
Up next, Frozen fans, the kids of all ages filling the theaters.
Obviously, just being here with her, she thinks it's super awesome, so anything that makes her happy, I'm happy, so I'm just happy to be here and see the show with her.
We're just excited, period. We love Frozen. We've probably seen it a million times, so we can't wait to watch it.
How about you? Who's your favorite character?
Anna.
I'm most looking forward to Olaf.
Sven.
Olaf.
Probably Elsa.
Why?
Because she has, like snow powers.
I'm assuming Elsa is your favorite character.
Yes.
Yes? Can you make a little snow for me?
I can't wait to see all the costumes.
I like the songs. We've heard them for, 10 years now? So it'll be fun to see them something different.
What are you most looking forward to tonight?
I'm excited to hear the singing.
It is phenomenal. So awesome. What's your favorite song?
Probably Let It Go.
You want to give me a little bit of it?
No.
Their favorite song is
Let It Go.
And they can sing it all in harmony.
Let it go.
We're ready to let it go. Let it go. So come, have a snow day with us. Frozen runs at Tanger Center from May 17th through June 4th. Tickets are available now at tangercenter.com. Availability is best for weeks 2 and 3. We hope to see you there.